Hey, what is going on, YouTubers? Feeling like sharing a bit of updates about my life again, so here I am. Once you got knocked down by depression, you are pretty much on your own. As a man, there aren't really many options. Nowadays, once you begin to completely lose your grip, it will mean once you begin to lose your grip. That pretty much means, you know, a day of utter doom and gloom to you. So that says you will have to make a choice, either to continue living in your life of misery and loneliness and seclusion, or just, you know, choose to end your life. Well, once you know those methods become available and accessible to you. So, well, I mean, there isn't, there aren't many things you can do except, you know, regaining some strength, regaining some focus, and then, you know, you fight back. Either you choose to remain a downer, or you choose to fight back and then got knocked down again, over and over. And that's pretty much the story of my life. Not sure about yours, but I suppose, you know, your life and mine should share something in common, and one of them can be a continuous or I should say a prolonged period of time filled with loneliness and disappointment, and then, you know, over time you start to forget, you know, when was the very first time that you got suicidal, and when was the first time you began to visualize, you know, how you plan to take your own life, how you plan to kill yourself. You know that can indicate that the severity of your depression has reached a new peak or a new pinnacle, and that can also indicate that, you know, your quality of life has reached a new historical low. Yes, so I wish I could just remain asleep for the whole day, but unfortunately, you know, I still woke up at dusk. You know, when the sky began to turn dark. In fact, you know, I just, you know, I kind of, you know, fasted for more than half of the day, and I just had, you know, one meal, and, you know, for today. You know, one reason why I chose to fast, you know, is I don't see, you know, the point of eating when I don't produce any value, you know, by working my ass off. Still, it hurts, you know, to fast. So I certainly don't recommend, you know, so doing to everyone. I suppose, you know, you should fast whenever you don't feel like eating, whenever you you had some food poisoning, and you need to get rid of the toxins in your intestines, in your guts, ASAP. Other than that, I don't see other, you know, I don't see, you know, how you can benefit from fasting, other than, you know, saving some bucks for yourself, so that you can feed your belly, you know, on the next day, and, or, you know, on the following days. But you know, unless you are currently, you know, you have more than one compelling reason, you know, to fast, then I highly advise against fasting. Yeah. So so tonight I just, you know, I, well, just things don't, things didn't go quite according to my plans today either. So that says I have to reschedule so many tasks, you know, to another day, to some other, to some other certain time in intervals on some other days, and it can get quite overwhelming. Yes. And it still seems next to impossible for me to launch my next Exodus mission. And but to make the matters worse, you know, it has gotten so hard to just make some money, just to make ends meet, even as a single man, as a Midtown man. Nowadays, not sure about the situation in Australia or in your respective home countries, such as the States or Canada or Great Britain, but you know, life nowadays in China has become pretty much a nightmare. As a freelancer, if you choose to boycott the system, to boycott a 9-to-5 corporate servitude, then you will be completely on your own. And not to mention, there are other mass surveillance systems in place to keep people like like me, like you guys, some of you guys, I mean, you know, in check, you know, highly supervised, highly, you know, closely and tightly monitored, so that, you know, they can, you know, extinguish your resistance, you know, at its very beginning, at the stage of Genesis. So everything, yes, in China seems so doom and gloom, and you know, more often than not, I just try to keep myself sane by, you know, to keep myself hopeful by, you know, by browsing, you know, the streets views on you know, the streets views of Belgium, of Switzerland, of Iceland, of some other countries, you know, just to soothe my current, you know, mental state of hopelessness, helplessness, and, and whatnot. Sometimes I even, you know, not just sometimes, but also more often than not, I browse on Flickr, you know, for, you know, both for not for safe contents and for, you know, both not for safe for work contents and for, you know, for safe for work contents, like just the landscape views of different places, different countries, different regions, blah blah blah. You know, just to keep, you know, try to soothe myself. You know, and you know, then I fantasize, I visualize about, you know, paying a visit or paying multiple visits to various places on planet Earth by, you know, by browsing Flickr, by either you know, browsing Flickr.com or Google Maps or both. Yeah, I know it sounds quite funny, but I am not joking here. Neither am I trolling here. It is the truth. Unlike my previous filming session, though. So not sure if tonight I should make another video about, you know, trolling, you know, trolling universities' online application systems throughout the whole world. It, you know, in particular, you know, unis in Belgium, in Switzerland, maybe also in the Netherlands. You know, just like to, you know, get myself more familiarized with how their systems work, so that I can, exploit their vulnerabilities, increase my chances of getting admitted to those universities. Well, I have no crystal clear idea why I am doing this, but I can also search particular behavioral pattern of mine to maybe also to boredom, to even to depression, to various factors and rogue elements that tend to occur to me. But in any regard, I suppose I should get back to work. So yeah, thank you very much for watching, listening to this video. let's hope I don't, you know, my appearance in this particular filming session doesn't scare you guys, since I suppose I look like a piece of crap on camera tonight, do I? Yeah, but in any regard, yeah, I hope to see you guys next time on YouTube. If God's still willing, so stay tuned. And take care. Try not to lose faith. So yeah, cheers and goodbye. Au revoir.